Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about converting from rectangular coordinates to polar coordinates. Briefly, let's talk about what a rectangular coordinate is. Rectangular coordinates are found with the ordered pair xy, and we know that polar coordinates are found with the ordered pair r theta, where r is a radius and theta is the angle created by that radius. And we're going to take a look at an example here. We want to convert the rectangular coordinates of 6 root 3 comma 6, where that's my x value and that's my y value, and I want to convert that to something that's in the form r theta. Well, we're converting from rectangular to polar and vice versa. There are some formulas that we need to know. These formulas can be derived from the unit circle. Please view some of my previous videos to see how some of these equations and values are derived. But let's take a look at one of those now. One of them is that x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Actually, this is also an equation for a circle. And another relationship is that the tangent of theta is equal to y over x. And we're going to use these equations to our advantage because we're given an x value and a y value in the problem. So let's start by first making this substitution here. We know that x is 6 root 3, and we're going to square that. And then we know that y is just 6, and we're going to square that. And from our equation, we say that that's equal to r squared. Well, 6 times 6 is 36, and root 3 times 3, I'm sorry, and root 3 times root 3 gives us 3. And here I have 6 squared, and that's just 36. And again, that's equal to r squared. 36 times 6, that's equal to 108, plus 36, again, still equal to r squared. Let's evaluate on the left-hand side here. Those two numbers add up to 144, and that equals r squared. Good news for us is that we have to take the square root of both sides, and 144 is a perfect square, so that answer is 12. So we see that r equals 12. So we have one of the numbers that we need for our polar coordinate. So we know the radius is 12. Now we need to find out what theta is. Well, we see the relationship to find theta is going to be the y value over the x value. So let's write this here. Tangent theta is equal to the y value that we're given, which is 6, over the x value that's given, which is 6 root 3. All right, this fraction here I can simplify. These 6's cancel out, so this is really 1 over root 3. So I have tangent theta is equal to 1 over root 3. Now I'm going to use this to my advantage to create a special triangle to see if I can figure out what that value of theta is. So I'm going to draw my right triangle. This here is angle theta. The x value, we see we are simplified down to be root 3. And the y value is 1. And if we remember about our special triangles, if I see a 1 and a root 3, I know my hypotenuse has to be 2. And I also know that opposite the angle, if I see a 1, I know that that value is 30 degrees. So this means that theta here is 30 degrees. Opposite the 60 degrees is root 3, and opposite the hypotenuse is 2. So here I see that theta is equal to 30 degrees. So I could say 12 comma 30 degrees, or I can use the radian measures and say 12 comma pi over 6. Alright. Well, that concludes this video from Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook or subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the name Spell Tutorial. Thank you for watching and have a great evening.